you ever wanted to smell like you're being embraced by the spirit of death? There's a perfume for that.
Not in anger, not in wrath. The Reaper came today. T'was an angel visited the green earth and took the flowers away.
Thanks for tuning in. We are gathered here today to discuss one of the most horrifying perfumes in my collection. And what's it called? The People You Love Become Ghosts Inside You by Death Floral. I came across this brand a couple of years ago, and as I was perusing through their online perfume catalog, I came across a description for one of their scents that compelled me to order a sample ASAP. And I'd like to read it for you right now. Heavenly musk, lingering funeral flowers, cold scent of vanilla in an empty corridor, handprints on a foggy window. And then there's a warning. Notice, the people you love become ghosts inside you is a heavy atmospheric that has been reported to cause feelings of intense emotion and is sometimes unpleasant in its vulnerability. Not for the faint-hearted. Okay, sounds pretty interesting, right? Here's the thing though, a lot of perfume companies make these claims. They're all saying the same thing, that they're captivating, compelling. I've heard it before, but oh boy, let me tell you, they were not kidding around with this one. This perfume is an atmospheric, and in case you don't know what that is, it is a perfume that is designed to convey a certain vibe, transport you to a certain place and time, that kind of thing. And what is that vibe? Death and grief. When I took this out of the mail and I smelled this, I let out an involuntary gasp because this triggered two very specific memories in my life, and I thought I'd share them with you. I think that's the best way to convey what this actually smells like. So, buckle up, it's story time. When I was a freshman in college, I had to take a gerontology class. The whole class was about aging and old people, okay? And our final project for that class required us to go to a nursing home or a retirement home and interview an old person, ask about their life, that kind of thing. I ended up going to this retirement home that was just off of campus, and I scheduled an interview for this woman who had been a resident there for a long time. I'm not proud to admit this, but I barely remember a word that this woman said to me because the stench in that room almost knocked me off my feet. It was a combination of bile, vomit, sweat, that old, unwashed, old people kind of smell. And then somewhere in that mix was like a cocktail of like industrial strength chemical cleaning products, okay? That room smelled like medical death. If you've worked in healthcare before or with hospice patients, you probably know exactly what I'm talking about when I say that smell. I remember feeling incredibly sad for this woman because one of the few things I remember her telling me is that she had fallen about a year prior. She had shattered her hip. And because of her injury, she had not been able to get out of her bed for a year. She hadn't been able to walk on her feet. She had been stuck in that shitty little hospital cot for over a year. I mean, imagine being stuck on a hospital mattress, being hooked up to a catheter, surrounded by all these flower arrangements, which I'm pretty sure someone just put them in there to try to cover up the smell. The feeling of death was very much present in that room. It was a very heavy feeling, and I could not wait to get out of there. Memory number two. The following semester, I had to take an anatomy class, and one of the requirements for that class was we had to work with a real human cadaver, and I was not prepared for that smell. When they unzipped that body bag to reveal the cadaver, the formaldehyde stench that just emanated, you know, seeing a dead body in front of you, it's kind of hard to wrap your mind around what that feels like, but the smell, it was like someone had taken a jar of pickles, aged a couple hundred years, and had accidentally dropped it, and the smell just exploded. That formaldehyde smell is deeply embedded in my brain. Which brings me to my next point. The heavenly musk note in this perfume, I am convinced that this is actually some type of formaldehyde that they put in here. Imagine being in a hospital room visiting someone on the brink of death. The nurse just came in and cranked the heater up. It's in the dead of winter. There's this faint, stale stench of urine, sweat, despair. Now, most people probably don't want to smell like that, and I include myself in that group of people. But I feel like some perfumes exist not to garner compliments, not to make you smell good, but to create an olfactory experience that you're not going to forget. This perfume will haunt you. The vanilla note in this is what makes this somewhat wearable. I've heard people describe death as being sickeningly sweet. The vanilla in here is the only faint bit of sweetness you get, and I think if it was not included, this would be just downright foul. Inclusion of this is kind of smart. It reminds you of that sickeningly sweet death smell, and it kind of pairs well with the flowers. It makes it perfumey, but still intensely sad. Is it a work of art? Yeah. Do I want to smell like this? No! I don't, but that's okay. This is the only 10 in my collection that I never, ever want to wear. Every now and then, I'll take this out of my cabinet. I'll give it a whiff. I'll get that bone-chilling sensation going down my spine. I'll shudder, and then I put it away. There's certain perfumes in my collection that are like that. I don't wear them, but every now and then, I just want to smell something funky and different, and this will scratch that itch. And you know what? I want to give a round of applause to the perfumer who came up with this. The perfumer's name is Brim De Los Reyes. I hope I pronounced that correctly. You really did the damn thing with this one. When people say that perfumery is an art, this is what they're talking about. Perfume is not just about smelling like a bouquet of roses, a big slice of cheesecake. And now you're probably wondering, well, who is this for then? I can only think of two situations where you would wear this. One being, maybe you're like me and you're just curious to see what that smells like. That's number one. The other one, if you've ever called out of work, we've all been there. You just want a day off and you have to come up with some excuse. So you tell your boss, oh yeah, you know, my great uncle's half removed stepsister's grandma just passed away and I'm gonna need to take a couple days off to process that. But your boss is suspicious. They don't think you're telling the truth. Well, you know what you do? You put on your grieving garments, you get this perfume, you slather it on. Next time you go into work, do those things, no one will question your story. That's how accurate this is. I'm not sure that I would want to smell like this ever, but if you went into work after coming up with an excuse like that, they may even tell you to go home early because they don't think you're done grieving. Well, those are my thoughts. I'm gonna go see what Molly thinks of this one.